Welcome back to the May 2021 Capital Region Real Estate Market Update brought to you by the Field Team. We're going to take a look at the four major counties, Albany, Rensselaer, Saratoga, and Schenectady. And we're going to take a look at the following: the number of new listings hit the market, the total number of contracts signed, the number of closings, the current market absorption rates, average sale prices, and then at the end, we're going to finish it up with a quick recap.
Let's compare the number of new listings to hit the market this past month and compare that to a year ago. We saw a total of 1,187 new homes hit the market in April of 2021. This number was almost three times what we saw from a year ago. It's important to keep in mind that as a result of the COVID shutdown, April of 2020 was the worst hit month last year. For greater perspective, if we were to compare back 2 years ago, April of 2019 produced just over 1,000 new listings. It's somewhat surprising that we are ahead of 2019 from a new listing standpoint. Without having the data available, you would think we are way behind in the new listing inventory.
Now let's talk about contracts. There was a 49% increase in the number of contracts signed. This figure is not at all surprising, being that April of 2020 was the hardest hit as real estate activity was mostly shut down. Now let's talk about closings. Compared to April of last year, we were up 10% in the total number of closed sales. Out of the three stat comparisons, closed sales changed the least year over year from 2020 to 2021. Now let's talk about the days on market. This number represents the amount of time a property sits on the market before an offer is accepted. The average days on market was 34. Of the four major counties, Albany had the lowest at 25. This is the first time in over 12 months that we have seen Albany County with the lowest average days on market.
Okay, so let's talk about absorption rates. When meeting with our clients and when talking to buyers and sellers, this topic is the most intriguing and important topic around the market. 0 to 3 is a seller's market, 3 to 4 is a neutral, and 4 and above is a buyer's market. Right now, the overall current market absorption rate is 2.7, which is slightly lower than last month. For the last few months, this score has been hovering between 2 and 3. For the most active markets that we track, 88% of these micro markets are favoring sellers. Last month, that score was the highest we have ever seen, and since then, it's increased by 4%. This has continued to rise for 4 consecutive months. This is further proof that the market continues to aggressively favor sellers. Let's take a deeper look at the entry level, middle market, and high-end price points. We define the entry level price point at 0 to 300,000. This overall absorption rate is 0.9. This number has remained unchanged since last month. The middle market is defined as the price range of 300,000 to 500,000, and that score is 2.4, which has also remained unchanged from a month ago. The local high-end or luxury market is set for any homes above 500,000, and that score came out to 4.9, which is down 9% from last month.
Here's what we're seeing with median sale prices year over year. Albany is up 10%, Rensselaer is up 11.1%, Saratoga up 15.4%, and Schenectady also up 15.4%.
Now for some final thoughts. The spring market is here. For different reasons, it's not the typical spring market that we're accustomed to. As you can tell by most of the data, the market is still starving for inventory. Discussions in the market around the lack of inventory, how long prices will continue to increase, and what's the long-term outlook on new construction. Now more than ever, experience matters in today's market. And if you're thinking about buying, selling, or investing in real estate in the Capital Region, call, text, or send us a message today so one of the Field Team members can follow up with you and assist you with your real estate needs. And that's what we call the home field advantage.